This video explains how to dry grains after harvest by using the high-velocity solar grain dryer. Instructions on how to build the high-velocity solar grain dryer can be found in our other animation titled Postharvest Loss, How to Build a Solar Grain Dryer. Drying grain is important because it reduces the chance for mold growth in the grain, which will increase its storage life as well as ensuring that it will sell at a higher price. Drying grain will not get rid of mold. You must start this process with clean, healthy grain. When using the solar grain dryer, you can place up to 500 kilograms of shelled or on-cob maize to be dried on the tarpaulin. In this animation, we will be using maize as our grain, but this solar grain dryer can be used with other grains. The maize should be distributed so that its depth is no more than 15 centimeters across the tarp, keeping it away from the edges of the tarp. If drying unshelled maize, spread it no more than one cob deep. Using your hands or some other tool that won't tear the tarp, make 7 or 8 parallel rows of maize with the furrows as deep as possible. Once completed, cover the maize with a clear plastic sheet and secure it with the same rocks securing the tarp. Make sure nothing is preventing air intake by placing small rocks on top of the large rocks that the sheet is resting on. Allow the maize to dry undisturbed for 2 to 3 hours. At that point, uncover the maize and mix it with a rake or shovel. Then, recreate the 7 or 8 parallel rows and recover the maize. Continue to uncover and stir the maize every 2 to 3 hours until kernels sampled from the center of the grain bed have reached the desired level of moisture. We recommend using a moisture meter to measure the grain's moisture level. The number of cycles required depends on the weather conditions and the grain's initial moisture level. Using this method, you can ensure that your grains will be kept dry, which will help them last longer and fetch a higher price in the market.